Welcome on back in. So, believe it or not, more than 50 million people will be betting on Sunday's Super Bowl. It's not all fun and games, though, because listen to this. More than 200,000 Ohioans are estimated to have a gambling disorder. So here to talk about these gambling problems, these gambling disorders, is Dr. Chris Toole, the Clinical Director of Addiction Services at the Lindner Center of Hope. Doctor, we were just speaking during commercial break because I interviewed you about 6 months ago when Kentucky legalized gambling, and it was so important then to really kind of make people aware of the dangers of this, right? It's always promoted to be, you know, fantastical and you're going to win and everything, but you are truly able to see the backside of that, the other side of that. Talk to us about that.
Yeah. Well, thanks, Jordan, for having me. Yeah. You know, most people can gamble. It's not a problem, right? It's fun, it's entertaining, but for some people it becomes problematic, out of control. So we know in Ohio about 255,000 people have a gambling problem disorder. And with that, we believe about 1.8 million in Ohio are at risk for more of that problem gambling. Sure. So about almost 19 to 20% of the population. We do know some things in regards to mental health and that relationship, that people who have problem gambling are twice as likely to have depression. People with problem gambling are three times greater to have drug and alcohol problems. 80% of people with problem gambling are more likely to have issues about gambling that they don't really realize the impact that it's having upon them. Most of those people don't get help. And then we know about 32% of the people who have problem gambling also have had thoughts about suicide. So we know, for example, Las Vegas has been one of the cities for a number of years that has had the highest suicide rate of any city. We know about 34 people per 100,000 per capita is that number in Las Vegas, as compared to Cincinnati, which is about 14. So we see a growing problem.
Absolutely. And I want, you know, folks at home, because again, like we were talking about, it's very easy to commercialize it and make people think that it's all just fun and games. Right. But what should some, you know, folks who are listening at home, what should they be looking out for in terms of, okay, now this is kind of beginning to trend into a problem area? What should people look out for?
Right. So if there's a preoccupation with it, it's really consuming my thoughts on a daily basis. Right. I try to stop, but I've been unsuccessful. When I do stop, I feel agitated, irritable, depressed. I may seek out money from family and friends. You know, we know that a lot of times I may continue the behavior despite the negative consequences. That's the true essence of addiction. So right. I may lose my job, lose my marriage, go to jail, and I do it anyway.
I've heard before the kind of the way that addiction goes is it starts with fun, then it's fun and problems, and then it's problems. You know, so it's kind of this several tiered, you know, step really in terms of just kind of going the wrong way. Again, we're talking about a huge betting weekend, probably
right.
One of the biggest, if not the biggest. Where should people go? Where can they go? You know, maybe if they just want to find out more, if they just want to figure out kind of what to look for, maybe it's their spouse, maybe it's their kid, you know, maybe it's their uncle or aunt. Where could they go to find that information?
Well, there is the Ohio Problem Helpline that people can call to get help. Actually, that access to that hotline has increased 55% since we started sports betting a year ago.
Oh my goodness.
So they can go to that website. There's various Ohio websites, you know, stop before you play, being able to be aware of what are some of these traits, some of these problems that people maybe might be exhibiting, and where to get help for that.
Absolutely.
So at the Lindner Center, we do mental health work, and we see this correlation between depression, anxiety, trauma, with substance use, as well as addiction, right? So a person needs to really look at that addiction piece. What are those mental health issues that might be interplaying with that, like depression, anxiety, and trauma, and then get help to really address that issue.
Absolutely. Doctor, thank you so much. You always come in with so much wisdom and just clarity of thought. I really appreciate you being here today.
Can you say that to my wife about
the
wisdom?
Yeah, right. He's very wise. All right, 10:45. We'll be right back. Thank you.
Thank you, Jordan.